Our journey begins on Earth, the third planet from the Sun, and the only known planet in our solar system to support life. As the camera pans across our breathtakingly diverse planet, we learn about its unique position in the habitable zone, where conditions are just right for liquid water to exist on its surface. This is crucial for the existence of life as we know it. Earth's atmosphere is a delicate balance of nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, and trace amounts of other gases. This composition allows the planet to maintain a relatively stable climate and provides us with the air we breathe. We also take a moment to appreciate the importance of Earth's magnetic field, which shields us from harmful solar radiation and helps maintain our atmosphere. As we prepare to embark on this incredible journey, our first stop is the Moon, Earth's only natural satellite. The Moon is tidally locked with Earth, meaning that one side always faces our planet while the other remains hidden from view. This unique relationship has led to a fascinating geological history, with impact craters and lunar maria, large, flat plains formed by volcanic eruptions, dominating its surface. Our exploration of the Moon delves into its formation approximately 4.5 billion years ago, likely resulting from a massive collision between Earth and a Mars-sized body. This cataclysmic event would have ejected debris into Earth's orbit, which eventually coalesced to form the Moon. We also touch on the Apollo program, which brought humanity to the lunar surface for the first time in 1969, leaving a lasting legacy on our understanding of Earth's closest celestial neighbor. As we admire the Moon's desolate beauty and reflect on the challenges of living on this airless, waterless world, we prepare to venture further out into the solar system. Our next destination will be the innermost planet, Mercury. As we travel towards the Sun, we explore the vast distances involved in our journey and the challenges faced by space probes that have ventured into the inner solar system. As we approach Mercury, the smallest and innermost planet in our solar system, we are struck by its stark, cratered landscape. With no atmosphere to protect it from meteoroid impacts, the planet's surface is a testament to its tumultuous past. Mercury's proximity to the Sun, at a mere 57.9 million kilometers away, causes extreme temperature fluctuations, ranging from minus 173 degrees Celsius at night to 427 degrees Celsius during the day. We delve into the peculiarities of Mercury's orbit and rotation. It revolves around the Sun in just 88 Earth days, making it the fastest orbiting planet in the solar system. However, its rotation period is 58.6 Earth days, leading to a unique 3:2 resonance between its day and year, meaning that Mercury experiences 3 days for every 2 orbits around the Sun. Our exploration of Mercury also covers the discoveries made by the Mariner 10 and Messenger missions, which revealed intriguing details about the planet's composition, magnetic field, and geological history. We touch on the presence of water ice within permanently shadowed craters at the planet's poles, despite its close proximity to the Sun, raising questions about the potential for life in the most unexpected places. Leaving Mercury behind, we journey towards Venus, Earth's sister planet in terms of size and composition. Shrouded in a thick, toxic atmosphere composed mainly of carbon dioxide and sulfuric acid clouds, Venus is a world of extreme conditions. With surface temperatures averaging 467 degrees Celsius, it is the hottest planet in our solar system, hotter even than Mercury, due to a runaway greenhouse effect. We delve into the history of Venus's exploration, from early telescope observations to the Venera, Mariner, and more recent Venus Express and Akatsuki missions, which have provided valuable information about its atmospheric composition, surface features, and geological history. Our journey takes us over vast volcanic plains, towering shield volcanoes, and impressive rift valleys, showcasing the dynamic geological processes that shape Venus's surface. Despite the hellish conditions, we explore the possibility of microbial life in Venus's more temperate upper atmosphere, where temperatures and pressures are more Earth-like. The recent detection of phosphine gas, a potential biosignature, raises intriguing questions about the persistence of life in even the most inhospitable environments. Leaving the intense heat of Venus behind, we travel to the cold, dry landscape of Mars, the fourth planet from the Sun, often called the Red Planet, due to its rusty, iron-rich surface, Mars has been the subject of intense scientific study and the target of numerous robotic missions. As we descend towards the Martian surface, we encounter the largest volcano in the solar system, Olympus Mons, which towers 21 kilometers high, and the vast canyon system of Valles Marineris, which stretches over 4,000 kilometers long. We delve into Mars' geological history, exploring evidence of ancient river channels, vast lakes, and even a possible ocean that may have once covered a significant portion of the planet's surface. This evidence suggests that Mars was once a warmer, wetter world, with conditions that could have supported life as we know it. The search for signs of past or present life on Mars remains one of the great scientific quests of our time. The Martian atmosphere, composed primarily of carbon dioxide, is only about 1% as dense as Earth's. This thin atmosphere, combined with Mars' distance from the Sun, contributes to its frigid surface temperatures, which can drop as low as minus 125 degrees Celsius near the poles. We also discuss the challenges of future human exploration and settlement, from radiation exposure and limited water resources to the need for advanced life support systems and in-situ resource utilization. As we leave Mars behind, our journey takes us to the asteroid belt, a vast region of space between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter, where countless rocky bodies ranging in size from dust particles to nearly 1,000 kilometers in diameter are found. The asteroid belt is a relic of the early solar system, containing remnants of the building blocks that formed the planets. We focus on the three largest asteroids, Ceres, Vesta, and Pallas. Ceres, the largest and only dwarf planet in the asteroid belt, is of particular interest due to the presence of water ice beneath its surface and possible subsurface brine deposits. Vesta, the second largest asteroid, has a diverse surface with basaltic lava flows, suggesting a complex geologic history involving volcanic activity. Pallas, the third largest asteroid, is an elongated, irregularly shaped body, providing insight into the early stages of planetary formation. Throughout our journey through the asteroid belt, we discuss the potential for asteroid mining, which could provide valuable resources for future space exploration and settlement, as well as the ongoing efforts to track and categorize near-Earth objects that pose a potential threat to our planet. Our voyage now takes us to the realm of the gas giants, beginning with Jupiter, the largest planet in our solar system. With a diameter of 139,822 kilometers and a mass 318 times greater than Earth, this behemoth dominates the other planets. Jupiter's swirling clouds of ammonia and water, its great red spot, a colossal, centuries-old storm, and its intricate system of more than 79 moons capture our imagination. Jupiter's composition, primarily hydrogen and helium, is similar to that of the Sun, leading scientists to classify it as a failed star. We explore the planet's immense gravity and its powerful magnetic field, which generates spectacular auroras at its poles and protects its moons from harmful solar radiation. Among Jupiter's many moons, we focus on the four largest, the Galilean moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. Io, the most volcanically active body in the solar system, offers a glimpse into the powerful tidal forces generated by Jupiter's gravity. Europa, with its icy surface and potentially life-supporting subsurface ocean, is one of the most compelling targets in the search for extraterrestrial life. Ganymede, the largest moon in the solar system, boasts its own magnetic field and a complex geological history, while Callisto's ancient, heavily cratered surface provides insight into the early history of the solar system. Leaving the Jovian system behind, we travel to the majestic Saturn, the second largest planet in our solar system, famous for its stunning system of rings. Composed of countless particles of ice and dust, the rings stretch over 282,000 kilometers across, yet are only about 10 meters thick on average. We examine Saturn's composition, which is similar to that of Jupiter, with a focus on its unique features such as the mysterious hexagonal storm at its north pole. Saturn's atmosphere exhibits powerful jet streams and colossal storms, offering valuable insights into the dynamics of gas giant atmospheres. Saturn's diverse collection of more than 80 moons includes Titan, the second largest moon in the solar system and the only one with a thick atmosphere. Titan's nitrogen-rich atmosphere, vast seas, and lakes of liquid methane and ethane, and a possible subsurface ocean make it a fascinating target for astrobiology. We also explore Enceladus, a small, icy moon with geysers of water vapor erupting from its surface, hinting at a subsurface ocean that may harbor the conditions necessary for life. Our journey through the solar system continues with a visit to the ice giants, starting with Uranus, the seventh planet from the Sun. With its pale blue-green color, Uranus stands out as a distinctly different world compared to the gas giants Jupiter and Saturn. Its unique appearance is due to the presence of methane in its atmosphere, which absorbs red light and reflects blue and green wavelengths. Uranus is peculiar in that it rotates on its side, with an axial tilt of 98 degrees. This extreme tilt results in dramatic seasonal changes, with each pole experiencing 42 years of continuous sunlight followed by 42 years of darkness. We explore the possible causes of this unusual orientation, such as a massive collision with another celestial body during the early stages of the solar system's formation. Uranus has a faint ring system and a collection of 27 known moons. Among these moons, we investigate the five largest, Miranda, Ariel, Umbriel, Titania, and Oberon, each with its own unique geological features. Of particular interest is Miranda, with its chaotic terrain of cliffs, canyons, and craters, suggesting a complex geologic history shaped by tidal heating and past collisions. The last stop among the planets is Neptune, the eighth and most distant planet in our solar system. Like Uranus, Neptune's vivid blue color is due to the presence of methane in its atmosphere. Neptune is known for its powerful winds, some of the strongest in the solar system, reaching speeds of up to 2,100 kilometers per hour. Neptune's largest moon, Triton, captures our attention with its geysers of nitrogen gas and dust, a retrograde orbit indicating that it was likely captured by Neptune's gravity, and a relatively young surface, hinting at recent geological activity. Triton's surface features include cryovolcanoes, which spew a mixture of volatile substances like water, ammonia, or methane instead of molten rock. Beyond Neptune lies the Kuiper Belt, a vast region of icy bodies left over from the formation of the solar system. This region is home to countless small celestial objects, as well as several dwarf planets, including the most famous one, Pluto. Once considered the ninth planet, Pluto was reclassified as a dwarf planet in 2006 due to the discovery of other similar-sized objects in the Kuiper Belt. We delve into the 2015 New Horizons mission, which provided the first close-up images of Pluto and its moons, revealing a surprisingly diverse and geologically active world. From its towering mountains of water ice to its vast plains of frozen nitrogen, methane, and carbon monoxide, Pluto's landscape offers a fascinating window into the outer reaches of our solar system. As our journey through the solar system comes to an end, we turn our gaze beyond our celestial neighborhood to the vast expanse of the universe, where thousands of exoplanets, planets orbiting stars outside our solar system, have been discovered. This recent surge in exoplanet discoveries has been fueled by advanced telescopes and observational techniques, such as the Kepler Space Telescope and the Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite. We discuss the diverse array of exoplanets discovered so far, from gas giants larger than Jupiter to rocky, Earth-sized worlds within their stars' habitable zones, the range of distances where conditions might be just right for liquid water to exist. The discovery of potentially habitable exoplanets raises the tantalizing possibility of finding extraterrestrial life and has fueled a new era of astrobiology research. The final segment of our documentary delves into the future of space exploration, highlighting upcoming missions and cutting-edge technologies that will propel humanity deeper into the cosmos. We discuss current or upcoming missions, such as the James Webb Space Telescope, set to revolutionize our understanding of the universe by peering back in time to the era of the first galaxies, and the Artemis program, which aims to return humans to the moon and establish a sustainable lunar presence. We also explore the rapidly advancing field of commercial spaceflight, with companies like SpaceX and Blue Origin striving to make space travel more accessible and affordable. The development of reusable rockets and advanced propulsion systems, such as nuclear thermal and ion engines, holds the promise of revolutionizing space travel, paving the way for human exploration and settlement of Mars and beyond. Our epic journey across the solar system has taken us from the rocky inner planets to the gas and ice giants, and beyond, revealing the breathtaking diversity and complexity of our celestial neighborhood. We have witnessed the awe-inspiring beauty and power of our sun, explored the potential for life in the most unexpected places, and glimpsed the boundless possibilities of the universe that stretches out before us. As we conclude our voyage, we are left with a renewed sense of wonder and appreciation for the cosmos and our place within it. Our journey has not only illuminated the countless scientific discoveries that have shaped our understanding of the solar system, but it has also served as a testament to the indomitable human spirit of exploration and the insatiable curiosity that drives us to seek out the unknown. As we look toward the future, we are reminded that the vast expanse of space holds endless possibilities and challenges for humanity. The exploration of the cosmos is not just an endeavor for scientists and engineers, but for all of us who dream of the stars and wonder what lies beyond the horizon. With each new discovery, we are reminded that the universe is vast and mysterious, and that our journey through the cosmos is only just beginning.